was able to take the gas cap off of this other one over here, put it on this one. So it looks like I gotta take this fan shroud off because it's rubbing the fan. Should be able to swap over the filter and filter cover on it. We'll see what else they took off of it and see if we can get it going. This old one tore down. Hopefully this wire is still good because they crushed it in there pretty good for the ignition coil on this. I think it's a GX270. Got it washed up. Looks like it'll be all right. It's just nick the jacket that protects it. Let's put it on there and test it. Let's see if I can route this on here one-handed and still keep it in perspective for y'all. Exactly got anything fancy with the job. Yep, it just goes on there like that, and you have your harness that plugs in right here. We'll get these bolts started and we'll set the gap. you can use a couple of sticky notes or a business card to gap these things out, or you can use a feeler gauge if you want to get all precise. Just kind of snug it up and then pull out your spacer and spin it around. Sometimes you're going to have to fight compression. Make sure you're not contacting. I'm contacting a bit, so you just move it out a bit and we'll go from there. Now that that's set, it doesn't rub. You got a little bit of clearance in there. Get this put back where it needs to go. Make sure it's not hitting anything, and then put our inlet housing back on wherever the heck it went. To be continued. Got the housing back on there, of course missing the starter assembly. Ignition coil's on there good. Just checking this other side, they bent the hub guard for the blade, and the blade guard's balled up quite a bit. This one looks like it was dropped off a truck or something, but I'm gonna see what I can do to get it going again, or at least figure out what all it needs. Alright, that's about as good as it's gonna get to close on there. Until next time, gotta order parts now. Let's get back to this Husqvarna FS309 that pulled out of the scrap. I found that there's a broken bolt and it looks like it's threaded in. Let's drill this out. Out of there. Background noise, I turned the fan on because it's hot. Got the old one drilled out. Dug through my bolt pile. Got one that matches. Of course, you probably can't see it too well, but it does line up. Try a different angle here. Come on, focus. Does line up, but of course we got to change the threads in it. So they do get buggered up when you got to drill them out. Eight by 125 looks right. Come on, focus. Diameter looks good. Threads line up. Let's chase it out. Do have a tap wrench, but in situations like this, the tap wrench doesn't necessarily fit. So you got to get a little creative on the tool. Clean enough to put a bolt in it. And FYI, most of the stuff on here is metric. There it goes. One of these days I'm gonna get the right kind of camera for this. At least something to hold the camera while I'm working. See, I got this bent back pretty good. That took some maneuvering. I still need to tighten this up. See if I can get it to bind without slipping off. There we go. Sometimes you can hold it just right. Don't want it too tight though. A little bit more. A little bit more. Alright, we'll go with that.
Alright, let's get it down so I can walk.
Should be good enough to inspect the cracks now.
Alright, this will be kind of the common places you'll see these developed cracks on the frames. Usually down here at this weld, it'll start to crack. I've seen these tear off before. These all look like they're in pretty good shape. Check the other side. Yeah, this lower deck looks alright. That one looks fine. Run it back for a second and look under here at this, at the trolley. This basically is the trolley that raises and lowers the blade height. little crack back here as well. That all looks good. It's in pretty good shape other than they scrapped it out and threw it away. What do you know? Found one I can take some parts off of and could make at least one good saw out of.
Thank you. Thank you.
so just put the contact block. To see if it's got gas in the bowl. Now let's hope that induction feels good. Shroud adjusted, the fan adjusted itself to the shroud, so, and the motor works. Let's go from there. Got it cut off of there. I guess we'll get it put on there in the morning. See how it goes from there.